Shalom. We the Hebrew Israelites come out here week in and week out to prophesy the judgment, the downfall of this wicked ass society, known as America.
Right.
As I'm doing that, we'd like to give all praise, honor, and glory to our power, Yahweh, by Hashem, Yahweh Shai. We also like to give a double honors to our apostles, a great millstone, who teach the rule well. That shit gonna melt. Who teach the rule, teach the rule well. And a piece of salutation to the elect Akim out here pushing this truth and during this fight, man, laboring with faith, hope, and sincerity. So yeah, I mean, hey, we just gonna pick up from where we left off yesterday, man. Basically, it's all good. How Russia is now on the response from America attacking Syria, you know? Because America in itself has been a bully across the globe, you know, trying to enlarge its place, trying to destroy everything that is righteous, everything that Yahweh by Shemi Awashah set up in its entirety. So what we're out here to do is to give warning, okay, to our people, you know, to cry aloud, as scripture says, you know, spare not. And to show our people their transgressions, primarily living under this cloud, okay, of America, this disguise of democracy, okay, which is really setting you up for a new world order, okay, which is putting a microchip in your right hand or in your forehead, okay, making you a permanent slave to these global elite bankers. Okay?
Yeah.
Right. Hey man, you know your nationality, bro?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. See, hey, that's why cats like that, man, in this upcoming day of martial law are gonna be the first to go. You know? They got all this pride, all this gumption for the so-called white man, but don't know who they really are, man. So in this upcoming day in which America's gonna be judged by thermonuclear fire, these people are gonna realize that, as the scripture says, a prophet was amongst you.
That's right.
Yeah, I got this for you, bro. This is Revelation chapter 13, verse 11. And I beheld another beast cometh up out of the earth, and he had two horns like a lamb, and he spake as a dragon.
Right.
And he exercised all the power of the first beast before him, and caused it the earth and them which dwell therein to worship the first beast whose deadly wound was healed.
Yeah, that's talking about the so-called white man, and this wicked-ass society, right? This whole mark of the beast, this RFID microchip, you know? Because, like...
Oh, the what?
That's exactly what the so-called white man wants our people to do, you know? Yeah. Under his system of white supremacy, you know? Which is really the destruction of Yahweh Shai, which is ultimately blasphemy, you know? As the scripture says, man, hey, that's the only sin in which a man cannot be forgiven of. And that's everything that the so-called white man has been doing. So his whole existence has been based off of lies, murder, torture, corruption, idolatry, witchcraft, you know? And like we had talked about yesterday, this spell is part of the reason why our people are in this state, you know? Worshiping false idols, thinking that the so-called white man is God, you know? So his whole beast system, okay, his whole philosophy is to destroy your spirit, okay? To corrupt you and make you more carnal as he is, you know?
Right, Esau wants to destroy any and all sense of spirituality, true spirituality of the Hebrew Israelites, because at the end of the day, when you really look into it, only the Hebrew Israelites are spiritual.
Right.
And that's going specifically toward that Israel of Yahweh by Hashem Yahweh Shai, that elect. We incarnate true spirituality, because only those who have a connection with Yahweh by Hashem Yahweh Shai are the ones that are spiritual. And Esau, everything that he works for and sets up is to destroy that connection with Yahweh by Hashem Yahweh Shai.
Quran. You got more?
Yeah, yeah. Because I'm going to read on down. It says, verse 12. This is, right, this is Revelation chapter 13, verse 12. And he exercised all the power of the first beast before him, and caused it the earth and them which dwell therein to worship the first beast, whose deadly wound was healed.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, hey, everything that the so-called white man does is based upon trying to have him worship you instead of Yahweh by Shemiah Oshai, in a nutshell, okay? Hey, all his TV shows.
Let's worship him.
Huh?
Having us worship him.
Oh, okay. Salakia, I'm about to say it. Okay. Salakia, to have us worship him instead of Yahweh by Shemiah Oshai, okay? Yeah, his TV shows, okay? All his news clips, you know? His whole vibration is anti-Messiah, you know? And as scripture says, there are many anti-Messiahs, okay? It's not just one, but he's the focal point, you know?
Oh, and that beast, so you can know that beast is talking about Rome, that first beast, because it said he exercised all the power of the first beast before him. Hey, that's ancient Rome. So right. Where are we living right now today? What is this spiritual?
Right.
This is the revised Roman Empire, the last leg of Rome. So this devil Esau, these so-called white people have reconstructed Rome. All right? Let's see, yeah, it says, it's again verse 12, and he exercised all the power of the first beast before him, and caused the earth and them which dwell therein to worship the first beast, whose deadly wound was healed. Right, because that deadly wound was laid on ancient Rome by the Israelites.
Oh, gone.
When you go back to Septimius Severus, you had Percinius Niger and others who took down Rome from within. They put that deadly wound on the beast, which was ancient Rome. And then guess what? Jake took over Rome. And it became the Holy Roman Empire.
Right.
And then Esau came back into power. He dubbed it the Renaissance, his rebirth, and now he's reconstructed Rome. All right, verse 13. Right, it said whose deadly wound was healed. Right, that deadly wound was healed beginning in the Renaissance era, age. Verse 13, and he doeth great wonders, so that he maketh fire come down from heaven on earth in the sight of men. And that's going into those bombing campaigns in Kosovo. So that was during the 90s under Bill Clinton. They did what they call the scorched earth policy in Kosovo and shit. And you can look that up. You can go into the history of that. That's what that's talking about. Because at one point in time, you know, we was pushing that, was talking about that was going into Hiroshima and Nagasaki, but then Apostle Tahar came back and he corrected that. That's talking about the scorched earth campaign when NATO, because this is going into NATO. Just talking about that second beast, that beast out of the earth. Which America is the spearhead of NATO.
Go ahead, huh?
So they are, come. So that took place in the early 90s, in the Clinton administration. It's Kosovo, I forget the other. But Esau had a scorched earth campaign. He went through and bombed all this shit over there, man. I really need a map right now, but you brother can look into that. This is what this is talking about. Because that during World War II, that beast really didn't come about till after World War II. So anyway. Alright, I'm gonna read 13 again. Then we're gonna get to the point. The point is 14. It says, and he doeth great wonders, so that he maketh fire come down from heaven on the earth in the sight of men, and deceiveth them that dwelleth on the earth by means of those miracles which he had power to do. in the sight of the beast, saying to them that dwell on the earth, that they should make an image to the beast which had the wound by a sword and did live. Verse 15, and he had power to give life unto the image of the beast, that the image of the beast should both speak, and cause that as many would not worship the image of the beast should be killed. And that image is Rome.
Yeah.
So it's saying that he reconstructed Rome all over again. That's all it's saying. He had power to give life to the image. You go to that word image is icon. In the Greek, icon means likeness. So he created his new empire in the image of his old empire, Rome. And when you look around, man, you go to any major city downtown, you're gonna see ancient Roman structures.
Right.
A lot of these churches, man, cathedrals,
right,
man, they built in the image of ancient Rome.
Right.
The you go to the, yeah.
Oh.
Yeah, yeah, architecture of ancient Rome. When you go to their school systems, Esau is gonna teach you Roman numerals.
Right.
By the time you hit the third grade, fourth grade, they're gonna teach you Roman numerals.
Right.
The ancient Roman terminology.
Yep.
You wanna study to be a doctor or a lawyer or a botanist.
Right.
All those are Latin terms.
Right.
You know, when you get down into, you get in depth study of medicine.
Yep.
Or law.
Yep.
Or you wanna be a herbologist, you better know them Latin names. You know?
Yep, the roads. Roads. How they say all roads lead to Rome.
Yeah.
I mean, so the whole we had talked about that, the highway system, you know.
Yeah, you're right. You're right.
Yeah, the highway system.
That, infrastructure and shit.
Yeah, done. Yeah.
Right. Read that again, verse 14. And he deceiveth them that dwell on the earth by the means of those miracles, which he had power to do in the sight of the beast. This devil is still doing that. He's still deceiving.
Right.
You know, but by those miracles. Because this is going into America and NATO. That's that beast, like the brother was showing them.
I got you.
Yeah, this that beast. So now what are they doing right now? The US and NATO. They got a campaign in Syria where they doing false flags.
Right.
So they can go into Syria and take that land over. And guess what? NATO is down with it. NATO is down with that. This is why World War III is gonna kick off. This is why all this is gonna lead with Trump sending those 59, 60 missiles into Syria to bomb Russia's toehold in that region. Because that was Russia has set up a base of operations right there. What they not telling you. That's why he gave warning, Trump, he gave warning to the Russians before he bombed. Because he didn't want any Russians to be killed, but some reports say that some Russians was killed in that campaign, that bombing campaign.
Right.
Some Russians were killed. So right, you're gonna see retaliation. And that's what the brother is speaking of, that retaliation.
Yeah.
So, right, NATO and that beast, beginning with America, they are still deceiving by means of those miracles, which they have you thinking they fighting for righteousness.
Right.
They have you thinking they're fighting for truth,
right,
and goodness. But when you get down into it, when you dissect this devil's madness, when you know his MO, his method of operations, you understand that this devil is nothing good can come from his works. Everything he does is to gain control. And that's going back into what the brother is explaining. Everything he does is to gain greater control,
right,
over the population of the earth.
Right.
He is not for freedom. He is not for liberty.
Yeah.
He is not for righteousness. That's why the scripture says, when the wicked bear it rule, the people mourn.
Yeah. Come on.
You grab that real quick.
Come on, Proverbs
29. We'll get that right here, and then we'll get back and finish this off in Revelation the 13th chapter, because that's it's a lot of meat. Yeah. When you're getting into these prophecies, man, they let you know exactly what's going on in these days. Right here, right now, man, these scriptures that was written, now Revelation was written 2 days ago.
Right.
Meaning 2,000 years ago, and describes to a T what's going on right here in the earth, right now, today.
Right.
Perfect. Only the Most High can do that. Right. You're not going to find pinpoint accuracies in the Quran. You're not going to find pinpoint accuracies in the Egyptian Book of the Dead.
Gone.
None of these other books, man, can come close. That's why the scripture says, none shall want her mate, because there is no mate to the scriptures.
Right.
Period. Yeah, let's get that out.
It's Proverbs chapter 29, verse 2.
That's right.
Says, when the righteous are in authority, the people rejoice.
Right, there's no rejoicing in the world today, man. Even the earth is in mourning. The trees are in mourning.
Right.
Pastor Kabar spoke on that the other day, Friday, yesterday. How even the trees, you know, trees are living entities.
Right.
They are alive. You know, and they are in mourning. The scriptures tell you that. The trees are going to rejoice when this devil goes down, man.
That's right.
They're going to be happy when this devil gets taken out of power. So how much more are the people? Because the righteous are not in authority.
Right.
The righteous are not bearing rule over the earth right now. The righteous are in subjection to this goddamn devil.
Right.
The so-called white man. Yeah, bro.
It's Proverbs chapter 29, verse 2. When the righteous are in authority, the people rejoice.
That's right.
But when the wicked beareth rule, the people mourn.
See? It's mourning, mass mourning throughout the world. What you think they're doing over there in Syria? You think they're rejoicing? What about Libya? You think they're rejoicing in Libya?
Right.
Iraq, Pakistan, Afghanistan? You think they're rejoicing? No, they're in mourning.
Right.
Right here in America. It's great mourning. But people are so dumb down here in America, they don't even have the sense to know they're being oppressed. They don't even have the sense to mourn.
Right.
They think this is, you know, America's the greatest country on earth, and this is just the way things are supposed to be.
Yeah, they're actually rejoicing in it, you know?
They
rejoice. I mean, the That's same right. thing in which the so-called white man does was celebrating the destruction of the Native Americans, so-called Native Americans, okay, so-called Negroes, okay? He celebrates these wars, okay? He puts monuments up, you know? He'll declare it a holiday. So, yeah, like the brother's saying, these people aren't in mourning, you know? Hey, these people are rejoicing at the downfall of all of these other nations, okay? Because that's what the so-called white man does, man. He heaps other nations unto himself. And by doing so, he's doing the same thing in which he did in Rome, which is destroying other nations, okay? Trying to exalt himself as the king of all nations. Just like as we were talking about, as far as this beast, this whore, Salaki, this whore of Babylon,
that sits
on top of many kingdoms,
that's
you know?
Right.
Yeah, yeah, come.
That was it on that, man.
Yeah, yeah.
You finishing that, huh?
Yeah, yeah, that was it. I mean, I'm gonna jump down to verse 4. Let's see. Yeah, this verse 4 is Proverbs 29 and 4. The king by judgment established the land, but he that receiveth gifts overthrow it. Mm. So yeah, I mean, hey, and when you look at it, quote unquote, America's development has always been about trading and getting gifts from other nations, giving gifts to other nations, okay? To portray themselves as being, as the brother has said, this honorable nation, which other nations should follow. You know, the epitome of all nations. But if you look at Russia, Russia is still under that old ancient spirit, you know? That's why scripture says that they're gonna hate the whore, you know? What's that, Revelation the 17th chapter? How these other nations are gonna hate the whore, which is why Russia in itself